January 501. The life of Michael Peevey. It's not even a secret anymore. It's just blatant. California's top energy regulator rolls with power company executives behind the scenes. So I'm going to skip down this beginning introduction. Is about the San Bruno deadly explosion and all that debacle. That's another story that I will get into. But 3 weeks after they went to court, not even 3 weeks, CPUC staff members were grilled in Sacramento. Michael Peevey, president of the CPUC and the top energy official in the state, boarded an airplane for Madrid. He was embarking on a 12-day travel study excursion with stops in Sevilla and Barcelona, sponsored by the California Foundation on the Environment and the Economy. California Foundation on the Environment and the Economy, CFEE. Now that sounds like a pretty benevolent outfit, doesn't it? California Foundation on the Environment and the Economy, okay. Peevey's wife, California Senator Carol Louie, was along for the trip too. So were two other state senators, several members of the state assembly, CPUC Commissioner Nancy Ryan, and a host of representatives from the energy industry. The group included executives from Chevron, Mirant, Potrero Power, Covanta Energy, Shell Energy North America, and engineering giant AECOM. High-ranking executives of the state's investor-owned utilities also participated, including Fong Wan, the senior vice president of energy procurement for PG&E. Although strict rules normally govern commissioners' interactions with parties that have a financial stake in the outcomes of commission rulings, there wasn't anything especially unusual about Peevey traveling internationally with a group that included representatives from the same companies his regulatory commission oversees. Okay. I was trying to figure out what was the deal with the CPUC and songs. And now I get it. I totally get it. CFEE trips happen every year. No big deal. Nonprofit has footed the bill to fly groups of regulators, legislators, and utility executives to prime vacations destinies like Italy, Brazil, South America, wherever they want to go. I want to go play with the big boys. So, it's worth analyzing whether their relationship, shaped by vacations together at exotic locales, has grown too cozy. Well, let's see. Let's see how the big boys party. Now, this is not anybody, but this is what I imagine. This is what I imagine these guys. These fat cats out just partying up on our money. Oh yeah, look at them go. I'm sorry, I just had to play this because otherwise the story is just way too depressing. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, I got that out of my system. Yeah, these guys know how to roll. And cover each other's back, grease each other's palms. So, while Peevey is only one of a host of officials who attend CFEE trips, he has more than just a casual tie to the nonprofit. This is where it gets good. From 1973 to 1983, he served as president of the California Coalition for the Environment and Economic Balance. Okay, here's another one with a fancy name, which sounds like it's an opposition foundation, right? It's controlled opposition. I just heard Patrick Penry talk about this. And there was other stuff going on. I've been watching from Miss Milky the Clown. California Coalition for Environment and Economic Balance. That's an organization that the California Foundation on the Environment and Economy grew out of, and whose membership shares some overlap with the CFEE. So here you have two things. They started one, then they started another so that they could cover all their bases. Based in San Francisco, somebody told me, okay, you know, why don't you take all this information? Why don't you go complain to Governor Brown? And I thought, okay, I thought about that. So that's when I started doing a little research here. So listen to this. It gets better. Based in San Francisco, the CCEEB was founded by Edmund G. Pat Brown. Yeah, Governor Jerry Brown's father. That was in 1973. And the CCEEB backed a late 1970s proposal to construct a series of nuclear power plants along the California coastline. More recently, the group honored BP with a 2009 award for environmental education. That was shortly before the company and lax federal regulators were responsible for the worst oil spill in U.S. history. So what does this tell you? This goes all the way to the top. As far as, you know, in California. So there would be no reason to complain to Governor Brown. His daddy founded this CCEEB. I mean, it just gets better and better. Okay. So now let's take a look at the musical chairs. The musical chairs. Here's the meat and potatoes. This is how they all work. The CPUC, the Energy Department, the environmental departments, like the Foundation on the Environment and the Economy, they go from one company to the next. Even though there's conflict of interest there, it hasn't stopped them. And they're playing hardball, and nobody gets in. They're under complete control. Consumer advocates and a peninsula lawmaker have raised questions about whether a revolving door exists between California Public Utilities Commission and the company it is supposed to regulate. Here are just a handful of leaders. This is just a handful. You can imagine how many there really are. Frank Lid. Lid? Lid? Worked as an attorney for Pacific Gas and Electric for 16 years before being chosen as general counsel of the CPUC in 2008. Michael Peevey has served as president of the CPUC since 2002. Earlier in his career, he was president of energy company New Energy, Inc., and prior to that, led the utility Southern California Edison. He also sits on the board of many of these companies. Many of these companies, like the CFEE. Delaney Hunter worked as a legislative aide and energy lobbyist before accepting an appointment by Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger as CPUC's Director of Governmental Affairs in 2005. So first he was a legislative aide and energy lobbyist, and then good old Governor Arnie pulled him in and said, hey, come on, join the big boys. Put you on as CPUC's Director of Governmental Affairs. I know everything will be hidden that way. Let's break California. Left commission in 2008 to return to energy lobbying. And we wonder why the Golden State is in the shape that it's in. Here it is. Here it is, from top to bottom. Steve Larson served as CPUC Executive Director from 2005 to 2007 and was director of its energy division for 8 years before that. He left to become executive for a natural gas company. He now consults with energy companies for a public affairs firm. Well, yeah, now he's got contacts with the CPUC. Jesse Knight. Knight was appointed in 1993 to the CPUC, where he served until 1999. He then spent more than 7 years leading the San Diego Chamber of Commerce, after which he became the CEO and chairman of Utility San Diego Gas and Electric. You see how this works? Wow. This just amazes me. And it makes me sick to my stomach. So with that, we'll watch how these boys rock and roll, these fat cats. As always,